Hello, it's author Jeanne Bender, and I'm starting a little bit early today because this is my first Facebook session with Lindie Lou and you. So I wanted to come a little bit early to see who is going to log on to the event and say hi. So I see here an event log. And I'm waiting for somebody to write comments. And I'm sitting in my kids' corner, which I'm going to talk to you about. Oh, people are coming online now. Hi, Mary. It's so nice to see you. Oh, Sophia and Lily are watching. Hi, Sophia. Hi, Lily. Oh, here comes Steph. Steph says hi, so I can see that as well. Can any of you find a hearts button or a smiley face that you can push and see if it works? I'm just seeing what kind of comments I'm able to look at because we are going to start our program in 1 minute. Oh, there's Nancy. She says she can't hear me. Can everybody else hear me all right? Can you guys hear me? If you can, say yes. I'm getting hearts from Steph. Good to see you, Tom. Thanks for coming on. Can you hear me, Tom? It takes a little while for the messages to come up. So hopefully you can hear me because it is time to start our Lindie Lou and You program. Oh, good. Everybody can hear me. That's great. So let's begin. First of all, I want to thank you so much for coming to our Lindie Lou Books Group, Lindie Lou and You Kids Corner. And this is my kids corner. I have this really comfortable stuffed chair, and I have my books with me, and I have my Lindie Lou stuffy with me. Hi, Lindie Lou. And let's see, we have to make sure that you're nice and safe. There you are. And I have my cell phone. I have crayons in case I want to color. I have bookmarks in case I want to read something and mark my place. I have my cup of tea. And I have pens and pencils and tape and all kinds of fun things to do, little activities, which we will be doing during our show. Oh, it's so nice to see all these names coming up. So glad you could join. So, welcome to Lindie Lou and You Kids Group. Let's talk a little bit about the Kids Corner. As you can see, I've created this very special place in the house I'm staying in Wilson, Wyoming, which is near Jackson Hole. And when these program sessions run every week, you never know, I might be in a different place because I travel a lot. So I'm in Wilson, Wyoming. This is the little kids' corner I created today. I'd like you, boys and girls, to create your own kids' corners in your house and send me some pictures over the internet. You can post them on this group page if you'd like to share the picture of you in your kids' corner with others, or you can send it to my email address if you'd like it to be private at jbenderbooks@gmail.com. That's jbenderbooks@gmail.com. So let's talk a little bit about the program today. It's going to be once a week on Thursdays at 1 o'clock Pacific time. And I'm going to talk about all kinds of interesting things that I hope will give you activities and fun things to do during the summer. We're going to have a story time session where I'm going to tell you a little bit about the real Lindie Lou. Did you know there's a real Lindie Lou? I'm going to talk about the Lindie Lou characters and her brothers and sisters and other characters in the Lindie Lou books. So we're going to start with a story time. And if you ever have a story time subject that you'd like me to discuss, make a comment or send me an email. After the story time, I'm going to introduce you to some very important people. And I'm also going to teach, show you, tell you how you can win this Lindie Lou stuffy. We're going to give this Lindie Lou stuffy away at our program next Thursday. And there are a few little activities that you have to do in order to win Lindie Lou. And in the end, I'm going to have a question and answer section for you to ask me questions. So let's begin with the story time. I had a puppy named Lindie Lou who was very real. I was living in Seattle, Washington at the time, and I thought, I live in a house on a lake. Wouldn't it be nice to get a dog? And so I started researching on the internet, and I found out that there's a breed of dog called water dogs. And when I found this water dog section, I went on the internet and I started searching for water dogs. And I'm going to show you a picture of what came up. So I was on the internet and this is the picture I saw. Now, if you saw a little puppy like that, don't you think you would like to take her home and make her part of your life? Well, that's what happened to me that day. I found the real Lindie Lou and I brought her on an airplane from St. Louis, Missouri, where she was born with Joe and Sherry, all the way to Seattle, Washington. And so the first book is written about Lindie Lou coming to Seattle. It's called Flying High, Flying on an Airplane for the Very First Time, because Lindie Lou really did fly on an airplane to Seattle to come and meet me. And when she came to the house, she loved it. The floors were soft and smooth, and she started sliding around. So I created a game called the sliding game, which Lindie Lou loved. And she loved to go outside because we lived on a lake. There were lots of ducks, mallards, and they would come up on the grass and forage around for things to eat. And Lindie Lou would sit at the window and look at the ducks, and she'd want to go outside and play with them. And the ducks noticed Lindie Lou, and she noticed them. And do you know what? They started coming up to the window and tapping on the window at her, and Lindie Lou was going crazy, 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 going, oh my gosh, I want to go outside. Mommy, mommy, please let me out. So I would very slowly open the door because I didn't want Lindie Lou to catch the ducks. I just wanted her to play with them. And so I opened the door and she started scratching and the ducks started waddling away, and she would come out. And instead of running after the ducks, she crouched down on her paws and she started walking towards them like she was a cat, looking after these ducks. And they looked at her like, what are you doing? And all of a sudden she ran with all her might and the ducks scattered and they flew into the air. And Lindie Lou was a little puppy. She didn't know ducks could fly. She watched them fly and they were so amazing. And they landed on the lake. And Lindie Lou was so surprised. She didn't know ducks could swim. Well, I had taught Lindie Lou how to swim when she was very, very young. So she went into the water and she started swimming towards the ducks because she still wanted to catch them. And do you know that those ducks looked at her like, oh, so you think you can catch me? And they just turned their little bodies around and swam a little further out. Lindie Lou went a little bit further because she doesn't like to give up. And then they would go a little further, and finally Lindie Lou looked back at the shore and at me and realized how far she was in the water and thought, okay, I guess I'm not going to catch the ducks. And she turned her body around and swam back. And one of the things I loved is whenever she got out of the water, she would shake and shake and shake, and she had these big floppy ears which would fly all over the place, and she would get herself all dried off. And then she would go and sit in the sun. And that's my Lindie Lou duck story. But what this story I'm trying to mention to you is that there are certain people, animals, things in our life that change our life forever. And it's not something that happens very often. But when it does, it's something you want to share with other people, especially if that person's personality is really good and playful and respectful and polite and has qualities that actually make you a better person. So I know you all have puppies and kittens and hamsters and birds and all kinds of wonderful pets, and I know they're very special to you. But look through your life, and if you find that one really special personality, and it might be in the form of a dog or a cat, think about how special they are and what about them is special. And that's what happened with me and Lindie Lou, because she, for a dog, has a lot of integrity. She's polite. She doesn't really beg a lot. She likes to bark, but only if she's trying to warn me about something. But she has respect and she has a lot of trust. I would take her to the vet, and even when they took her temperature, she would just look at me and trust me that everything would be okay. If they had to give her a shot, she would look up at me and trust me that everything would be okay. And I just loved her personality. And that's why I wrote these stories for you, so that you can learn a little bit about life over the shoulders and through the eyes of Lindie Lou. So let me tell you one more little story, which kind of goes along with this respect part of Lindie Lou. So when we're in Seattle, Washington, we live downtown in a high rise, and we like to take the elevator down to the street and walk out to the street. And when we get out to the street, if I turn to the right, I go to Pike's Place Market. And if I turn to the left, I go into town and go shopping. So on the days that I decide not to go to the market, but to go shopping, I start turning to the left, and Lindie Lou gets all upset at me because she wants to go down to the market, because in the market, there's a man named Harry, and he owns a fish stand. And do you know that Harry gives Lindie Lou smoked salmon treats? And she's gotten used to these treats and Harry. So anytime I go the other direction, she knows how to get to the market. So I turn and go into town, and she, every time I stop at a stoplight, she sits down because she was taught to wait at the light sitting down, and she turns her head and she looks back at the market and she looks up at me like, aren't we going to Harry's fish stand today? So when I go shopping, she does get a little distracted because I go into the big department stores and all the ladies know Lindie Lou and they come running to say hi, and she wags her tail so hard her whole butt wiggles, and she has favorites in the stores who come every time she's there to say hello to Lindie Lou. So while I'm shopping, she's polite and she lets me do my shopping and say hello to all the people in the store. And then when we leave the store, she starts pulling me. Not very hard, but enough. And do you know, if I close my eyes, she would take me down the hill, into the market, all the way through the people, past the flower stands, past all the other fish markets, and go right to Harry's market, because that's where she gets the smoked fish. But this is the part I'd like to tell you about her personality. Lindie Lou goes to Harry. He says hello to her, but she doesn't jump up on him. She doesn't jump up at the counter. She sits and she waits for him. And he puts the salmon in his pocket, and she sits there, and her tag and tail and her whole butt is wagging, but she sits there very politely. And then when Harry says okay and hands her a piece of salmon, then she'll jump up and take the salmon, but very gently, because Lindie Lou is a very polite dog. And so you can learn lessons from dogs that also have learned lessons from me about sitting and being polite. You can learn lessons like that too. If Lindie Lou would jump up and try and grab the salmon. Harry would be really upset at her and say, "That's not for you," and she wouldn't get anything. But because she's polite, and because she waits, and because she treats him with respect, he gives her something in return. So that's my second story for today. So, boys and girls, I would like to know if you liked my story time lessons. So if you did, please type yes. And if you'd like me to do the story time again next week, please type more story time so that I know you enjoyed this part of our session. And now we're going to go on to the second part, which is when I introduce you to some very important people. So, do any of you know Nancy Kiefer? If you do, type yes, because Nancy knows Sophia and Lily and Mary and Steph and all Tom and a lot of the people who are watching today. And I would like to tell you that next week we are going to talk about Nancy Kiefer's role as the editor of the Lindie Lou Adventure Series books. So if you know Nancy, please type yes. We are going on 16 minutes already. Wow, the time really flies when you're having fun. And so it's time for me to tell you how you can win this Lindie Lou stuffy. Okay, so on our website, we have a coloring book page. And this coloring book page is so new that it will be up no later than tomorrow morning. So you might not be able to see it right away. I have to put it up on the website with the web designers, but we have a coloring page and it says Lindie Lou and You Kids Corner. And if you go on our website and you find this coloring page, you print it out and color it. And be creative. You can make her eyes any color you like, and you can make her tent any color you like. Print it out, answer the questions on the top of the sheet, take a picture of your coloring, and email it to me at jbenderbooks@gmail.com. And you must submit your coloring book page by next Tuesday. So today is Thursday, Friday, Saturday, Sunday, Monday, Tuesday. You have 5 days. And Wednesday, Nancy Kiefer and I are going to pick the winner. And we're going to announce the winner, show the coloring page, and that will be the person who's going to win this Lindie Lou stuffy. And we're going to announce it next Thursday at 1 p.m. So please make sure you color the coloring book pages and you get a chance to win this Lindie Lou stuffy. Now we are in the section of the program where you can ask me questions. So if anybody has any questions, please type them up on the screen. And I'm just going to wait a second. Oh, there's a question. Are all the puppies real? Well, that's a very good question. In the Lindie Lou Adventure Series books, there are 5 puppies. Lindie Lou is in the middle. She travels the world and learns life lessons along the way, and she never gives up, and she's very polite. Then over here, we have a puppy named Topaz, Lindie Lou's brother. And Topaz is a troublemaker. Can you see it in his eyes? Then there's a puppy named Jasper. Jasper is very playful. Then we have on the other side, Ruby, who's the runt of the litter and very curious. And we have Diamond, who's very, very shy. And so Diamond is real. This one over here. She really is real. And Ruby is real. But I made up Topaz and Jasper. And I want to tell you something very interesting about Diamond. She has a little diamond marking on her chest. And so that's why her name is Diamond, because she really does have a marking of a diamond on her chest. So if you go to lindielou.com and you go to the photos on the kids page, kids, photos, Lindie Lou, it's coming up. And we scroll down, I'm going to show you a picture of Diamond. There she is. And that white marking, when she's wet, is really the shape of a diamond. So Diamond is real, and so is Ruby. And Topaz and Jasper are made up. I made them up for the story. So thank you for the question. I think we're about running out of time for today. So I would like to thank you, boys and girls, to coming to our first Lindie Lou and You Kids Corner. Don't forget to make a Kids Corner in your house and send me either through this message system or on jbenderbooks@gmail.com pictures of your Kids Corners. I'd love to see them. And please come and join us again next Thursday for another fun adventure on Facebook, Lindie Lou Kid Books Group, the Lindie Lou Books Group for author Jeanne Bender and Lindie Lou and You Kids Corner. And thank you so, so much for joining our session today. And I'll see you next week. Bye-bye.